Well, hello everyone, this is game number 6, actually. I am going to start the video today from this game because the previous games weren't really that cool. We do have Galatia in our deck, let me show you the deck real quick right now, actually. But other than that, we haven't really pulled off any cool combo, so I would rather start by showing you this game. Let's see how this one is going to play out. I think I'm just going to start by using the extra mana and playing Call of the Light. Let's do that. Let's immediately get those Acolytes in my hand. I am going to play a couple of those Acolytes now, and that is going to be it. Huh? We really need to get rid of that creature. And luckily I have a way to do so. I am just going to attack here now, and then I'm going to play Canopy Barrage and follow up with another Acolyte. So life is good for now. That is a little problematic now because I can't get rid of this creature easily, so I think I'm just going to play the Parthenon Recruiter and end my turn. I don't want to trade both of these here. If my opponent uses the... Oh! Huh? Oh no! But we can still make an effective trade. However, I am going to attack this. Now the question is, do I want to play Poison Dart onto you? I can just play Galatia now that I think about it. Let's do that. Let's play on curve. Scorch Blade doesn't really help me here. Let me attack my opponent directly, and it's going to be it. Oh, Deadly Arsenal is good, however, for my opponent. Means that Galatia is going to go down now. Oh, and a Vexing Vicar. Interesting. Honestly, I can just make a very easy trade here. Let's do that. Afterwards, I think I'm just going to use my God Power or play Parthenon Recruiter and Scorch Blade. Let me use my God Power and then I'm going to just play Scorch Blade. I don't think I have any dragons in my deck, so I am not going to get any value out of it. Oh, Locking Disciple is good for my opponent. But what I can do... This is an interesting one. I can play Chaining of the Gods here, actually. Yeah, and guys, I think I will. Let me attack this. Let's get it out of the board. Then I can play you onto you, probably. I mean, I could also just play this, now that I think about it. Yeah, let me do that instead. Let's try to get plus one health. That's going to be good. That is not going to happen. So now I'm just going to make you a little stronger. And I'm going to end my turn afterwards. Oh, not Grendel. Come on. Grendel is so huge, always. Ouch. Yeah, now we're in trouble. Now we are in trouble. How do I get rid of Grendel, guys? Probably Chaining of the Gods. I am going to attack here. Actually, let me play that first. Let's make sure that we give Grendel minus 3, minus 2, and then I can make this creature much stronger. Oh, and actually, I can now use Amber Arrow. Ha, that's great. I kind of want to get rid of Grendel, guys, but I won't for now. Let me just play Hallowing Light here. Actually, do I really want to do that? I mean, yeah, let's make that stronger. Let's play towards our mana curve. Let me attack my opponent directly, and that's going to be it. Not Battle Cleric. Ouch. And another one. Honestly, I think I'm just going to play Amber Arrow here. Let's get rid of the Battle Cleric. And then I can just use my God Power, probably, and let me attack my opponent directly afterwards. Zealous March for my opponent. Actually, that is very, very, very problematic for me now. How do we even deal with that? How do we deal with that? We honestly can't. So, probably this is going to be game over. Let me just play you. Let's populate the board a little bit. Let's give it... It doesn't really matter here. Yeah, guys, now we're in a bit of a pickle. Zealous March on turn 7 with no removals is probably game over for us. So this run is just going to make it only up to 4 wins. I mean, look at that. Do we have any removals even? And Light's Levi, okay. What can we top deck to save us in this situation? Oh, Galatia, sure. Trial Spirit works too. And let me end my turn afterwards. Okay, I mean, we'll take all those trades, I don't really mind. And my opponent is just going to play an Acolyte afterwards, and another creature. Actually, that didn't go too bad. How do we play? I think I just need to play the Albino Hydra now. Let's put that on the board. Hey! Now, wait a second. Now the question is how I want to play this turn. I mean, I could play the Humbleburn Recruiter. Does it make sense for me to trade? Probably not in this case. So guys, this is going to be a race now. I am just going to play the Parthian Recruiter. I am going to make sure that you are at 6 health. And then I'm just going to use my God Power. And let's deal 6 more damage to my opponent. That's going to be it. My opponent has quite an easy trade here. This trade is going to happen now. Let's see where that is going to put us. Okay, that's going down. Okay, my opponent is making all the trades. Oh no, that is mine. Hey, don't steal that. That's mine. Don't be like that. Okay, so now what do we do? Oh, oh, that is a great draw for me. Let's say, let's make sure that you are confused, probably. And then I think I need to use my God Power. I can also play the City Sniper, now that I think about it. Let's make sure that you don't deal any damage when I attack you. Then I am going to attack here, probably. And I am also going to play the Spiritual Benefactor. Guys, this game is still not over. I don't know how or why. Because we had to deal with a Zealous March on turn 7 with no hard removals, so... I don't know, we're still here. Okay, the trades are going to happen again now. Finally we can get rid of Grendel. After 10 turn... Oh no! Oh yes, we can. Okay, we have Poison Dart. Let me just play Poison Dart here, obviously. Then I think I can just use my God Power. Let's keep the Militant Thirst in my hand. Let's finally get rid of Grendel. Finally. And that's going to be it. Oh no! Oh no! Wait, doesn't that have Bleeds too? I think that was a mistake. I mean, we can get rid of that. But I will probably have to trade all of my creatures. Let me just start by playing you. Then I am going to attack here, and then I'm going to play the Fir Tree's Fury. Let's make sure that we deal 5 damage to this. Guys, we're still alive. We somehow have the board, but my opponent has 2 cards and I have 0 in my hand. So let's see what they are going to play now. That is a small problem. Witherfingers is a top deck. Witherfingers is a top deck, and now I'm just going to attack my opponent directly here. And we are threatening to win the game now. Yep, guys, I think this game is ours. I don't know why we won this one. You guys are going to be like, oh, but you played Witherfingers to win. But my opponent also played Zealous March. So, let me just attack here and here. And that's going to be game over, actually. GG! We win another one. We are now at 5 wins. Let's see if this deck can make it all the way up to 7, guys. This is game number 8 of our sealed run. Let's see. This starting hand is not that good. Let's get rid of you. Let's get rid of you. Actually, this is much better now. I think I might just start the game by playing Call of the Light, so I am going to keep all of these. I could have gotten rid of Theric Blessing. Please don't play anything. Okay, that works for me. Let me just put the Night Elf Trapper on the board then, and I'm going to end my turn afterwards. Oh no! Oh no! Ouch, that hurts a little bit. I can actually just play this guy over here. And now the Woodcutter Imp is going to have slightly less strength, so we're fine with that. The Woodcutter Imp has a unique ability that after it attacks, it also deals damage to my opponent. And now, that is interesting. I think I need to play Call of the Light, and I'm also going to play Theric Blessing here. Let's get rid of that. And honestly, guys, afterwards I'm just going to end my turn. I'm going to preserve the extra mana. Oh, that is strong, however. But it means that I can play this now onto this creature. Let's make sure that we get rid of that, and we also summon a couple. And we also summon a couple of creatures here. Oh no, that is strong. Okay, guys, we lost the board. Now it is probably time for me to trade some of my Acolytes. Galatia is good too, but she's gonna go down very easily. So let me just play my acolytes, one acolyte, two acolytes, and then does it make sense for me to play Chaining of the Gods? Probably not. I'm just going to use my god power here. And actually, I am going to put down this acolyte as well. Okay, my opponent is going to attack directly. Blade Fly. Okay. Now Chaining of the Gods doesn't really make sense for me anymore. Oh, and two more mana. Wow, okay, that's aggressive. Where are the removals? We don't have any. We don't have any removals, so... Guys, this is probably City Sniper. We need to start trading the board instead of going ham now. Or I could just play Galatia. Yeah, let me do that, actually. Let me just play Galatia. Let's draw a card, that's going to be good. In a little bit. I kind of want to save the extra mana. Just so that I can play Witherfingers earlier. So let's just trade here. And then I kind of want to get rid of one of those two. Yeah, let's do that. Okay, that went well for my opponent. That also went well for my opponent. That was very, very easy. They got very lucky. But now we can play... What can we play? I can use my god power. I can play the Shield Bearer. And that's going to mana surge the Draka Warrior, so let's just play it afterwards. And I think, guys, that's going to be it for now. My opponent has a very easy trade here, obviously. Okay, they are going to attack with this first, I don't mind. Okay, that also works. I am probably playing the Witherfingers here, I think. Yeah, let's do that. Let's play Witherfingers. And let's get rid of that creature too. Now those creatures are asleep and they cannot attack. And they are probably going down on this turn too. Oh no, not Judge Envoy. That is strong, quite strong actually. How can we deal with it, is the question. I mean, guys, I could just play Chaining of the Gods. That is a very strong card, because yeah, I think that is going to be the case. Always, let's make sure that Witherfingers gets plus 2, plus 3, and then... This is going to be weaker. Now I can also play City Sniper. Right. Yeah, let's trade that. Let's get it out of the way. Let's make a trade here. We maintain the board. Please go here. Okay. And pack succession. So my opponent is going to summon that spider. That's okay for me. Amber Arrow doesn't really work for me here. Let me just play you, the Militant Theist, to get rid of that. And then I can just use my god power and deal 4 more damage to my opponent. Guys, it's not looking too bad. Oh, Helena is good, however. How do we get rid of it is the question. Actually, I will have to attack with a lot of my stuff. We are still going to survive just a little bit, but... It's gonna hurt. It is going to hurt. Let's play the Holy Enchanter too. Guys, we are going to have to attack with a lot of my creatures. We never really want to... that's going to hurt so, so much. Do I really break all of those three onto Helena? Yeah, kind of. We still maintain the board. I am not happy with this trade, however. But we still have to do it. My opponent is at 8 mana now, and yeah, we are getting into this zone. Canopy Barrage is good for me. I can also just play Amber Arrow, now that I think about it. Oh, by the way, I can just play Amber Arrow. And as soon as I steal this creature, I am also going to play the Lupine Wayfarer. It's going to give it Bleeds. Let's try to give it Ward too. We got lucky here. Let's trade here. Let me get rid of Selena immediately. And we're still going to deal some damage to my opponent. So that was a good turn for me. The Lupine Wayfarer has the ability to gain Bleeds if we control another wild creature. So as soon as I stole the Rain Badger, I had the ability to give Bleeds to Lupine Wayfarer. We don't really care about that. Oh! Okay, we'll take that. We will take that any day of the week. Galatia is huge, and actually we can play perfectly towards our mana curve. So guys, I think this is probably game over. Let me get rid of this. Then I can play Galatia. Let's see what we're going to draw here. Let's play you too. Then I'm going to use Canopy Barrage. And we are still dealing 4 more damage to my opponent. My opponent just drew a card. Let's see what they top decked. If they don't find something very, very, very good and strong, this game is ours. Yes, let's go. Guys, this is going to be the final. The next one is going to be the final game. Let's see if we make it again all the way up to 7. This is game number 9. Guys, this is going to be the final game that decides everything. Let's see if we can make it all the way up to 7 wins now. Or not. Okay, we have a very good starting hand. Do I want to keep that too? Probably not. Let's Amber Arrow is much better. Yeah, guys, the starting hand is very, very good. We are going to immediately put a lot of pressure on the board on turn 1. Actually, the starting hand is amazing. We even got something to play on turn 3. So unless my opponent plays something that is huge... Oh! Yeah, this is what I mean. Okay, now our plans are ruined and we are losing the game. That's it. GG. Why did you have to have Amber Arrow? I am probably playing you now. It doesn't really matter what we get here. Okay, luckily we got the plus 1 health. Oh, okay. Let's play Amber Arrow now, probably. I could just play you too. That is interesting. Guys, what do we want to do, actually? Let me play you. And then I'm going to end my turn. I think that this is slightly stronger than Amber Arrow. Because if my opponent chooses to just attack me directly, I can play better towards my mana curve on the next turn. Oh my god! Stop stealing my creatures! That's mine, what are you doing? Okay, let me play... what do I play now? Let me play Amber Arrow onto who? Yeah, I really need to play it anyway. Let me play Amber Arrow. Let me attack here, and then I can play you onto you. And I'm going to end my turn afterwards. My opponent has stolen 2 of my creatures already. Oh, that is strong too, guys. Guys, it sucks. We're losing the game. We are losing the game now. Lupine Wayfarer doesn't really help me here. I can't play Chaining of the Gods either. I need to play you. Let's try to... Actually, I think I'm just going to go with plus 1 health. Doesn't really matter anyway. 6 mana for my opponent? Yeah, okay. Guys, we lost this one. We lost this one. We are going to be denied the 7 win run by Asterius, the Betrayer. Get out of here, I don't want to see you anymore. Do we really have anything to play on the next turn? No, so we really need to top deck something huge. Born again! Are you going to get another Asterius? Are you out of your mind? Let me just play Galatea now. And we are going to get you, why not? Guys, it's not looking good. It is not looking good at all. My opponent is just going to play Asterius now. What? Single combat, okay. And we're probably losing the game now. Oh wait, my opponent is not... Huh? What are you doing, friend? We would have just won the game. Now we have a chance, but that is not going to do anything. Let me just play another Galatea. Let's give the thumbs up to my opponent. It was a good game. They came out on top. They had some very strong early game cards, and Asterius on turn 6 was huge. So let's just concede the game. GG, we are not going to get the 7 win run today, but that's okay. 6 wins is still very strong. Guys, today we made it up to 6 wins, and for that we are going to get 2 epic packs, 1 rare bounty pack, and 6.25 gods tokens. So let's move into the pack opening now. We're just going to open the 2 epic packs. Actually, guys, don't forget to subscribe because I am going to be doing a pack opening at the end of the sealed event. So I am saving up all of my packs up until the 14th of February. So don't forget to join the giveaway by making a comment right now. And don't forget to subscribe because we're going to be doing a huge pack opening very, very soon, in just about a week. So thank you all for watching. This is going to be it for today's video. We couldn't make it all the way up to 7 today, but still, we're going to be opening those legendary packs very, very soon. So see you all tomorrow, guys.